Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, I'm gonna show you how to paint the water on this swan painting here. So this is the palette that we're gonna use, but we did not use the Ross Vienna. So basically just four colors. And after a quick mixing process, start to build up the darkest spot on this painting here. And yeah, it's a round shape here, as you can see. And directly around this shape we have the brightest color, and that is the one that I apply now here on this scene here. Basically completely around this dark spot here, extending it a bit to the right side. And I mix in between color. And then I grab a fresh brush here, and this color is a bit darker, and with this color I start to build up this shadowy part of this reflection here. An important thing here is that you need to realize that I grab the color just once and not too much of it, and start basically to rub this tiny bit of color into the already dry background that we have. And you see, I don't grab any fresh color. The color on the brush gets less and less. And yeah, with this technique, basically, I can easily adjust the amount of color that we have on the painting surface here. And this way, it's much easier than trying to get this in wet. Here now I grab some fresh color here. But basically also just a tiny bit, and building up this whole thing, building up the 3D look of the small waves that they have here. And this is basically the technique that I use for giving this the shape to the waves that we have here. Sometimes using a bit more color. I need some brighter areas. And some other places I basically use a brush that has barely a hint of color on it, as you can see here. And this is a technique that you should try to practice on your first painting that you do like this. Not on the actual painting, but on some spare canvas or something. So that you can basically practice how much color you need. And this technique requires really, in some places, a bit more color, and most places just a hint of it. Here now I build up some reflections, some lighter parts. As you can see, putting on lighter color and basically rubbing it into the background. Not quite there, so I get in some lighter color again and start to blend again. And of course, don't forget to brush the color in all the places between all those small feathers. Here now we're a bit more further down, and I start to build up the shadowy parts in the front part here, and you basically see me putting in dark colors, lighter colors, the same technique, dry brushing a lot, as you can see, and giving this whole thing shape. And yeah, you know, I'm adding the reflections from this one, some darker, grayish, color. Not so much a blue one. It's not a reflection of this one. And note that the color is quite a bit darker on the water surface here. Here now we have a bit more into this whole process, as you can see. Just adding some more lighter tones here. Also the dry brush technique. Also brushing it in with the very dry brush. So we have a very soft and nice transition. It appears to be red on red painted, but it is, as you can see, just the dry brush technique. You know, I build up the reflection, this one. And again, you can see it's quite a bit darker than the original color. And in some places it fades out to the darker water. And this here, I would like to show you with this here, that the small details are a pretty important aspect of this whole thing. Getting some tiny darker areas, some tiny highlights in reflection. Basically all is put in with the dry brush technique. Putting in color, the right amount of color on the still wet, still dry, on the dry background, and basically rubbing it in, as you can see here. And I follow the reference material pretty close, and yeah, build up this thing step by step, and yeah, this is another thing that you should pick up here. Don't rush, take your time, and don't try to get it done with this with the first attempt, and go back and forth adjusting, and then you will end up with a pretty nice looking swan painting. And we're finished. You like to see more water painting tutorials? I got here a lot more of them.